So my lab actually works on nanotechnology for biomedical applications. So we're trying to develop new ways to detect diseases, as well as new ways to deliver drugs into disease sites. In the last 10 years, we've made a significant amount of progress in developing new types of materials that are in the nanometer size, which is about 1,000 times smaller than the diameter of a hair. And these technology allows us to design the properties of the material. So the properties refers to the optical, electrical, or magnetic properties of the material by changing its size and shape. So we can make one material to produce a green light, another material to produce a red light, and the only thing that we've done is change the size of the material. We're starting to now develop platforms that allows one to use these materials as a way to simplify and improve the detection of different types of agents. And these agents could include molecules in human, in animals, potentially also in plants and trees as well. But medical diagnostics or detection, not just medicine, but in biology, organisms, and all these things, hasn't really evolved to the point where we can communicate very rapidly. So the challenge here is now to integrate the nanotechnology with the cell phone technology, try and make something small enough that you can carry in your pocket, but then allows you to detect all these things as it's evolving. So you got real-time information of diseases, and diseases could be human or non-human as it's moving within the world. And then what we want to do is be able to use the cell phone as a way to image and analyze that information. And so if you can do that, then your cell phone becomes a source for you to diagnose whatever the disease is. If you're in a remote area in the world where you don't have any information, you don't have a specialist in that area to tell you what you detected, well, you can make your measurements and you can send them back to a centralized facility, wherever it is in the world, and have that person on the other end to interpret the result and send that information back. So if you need to treat something very immediately, you'll have that information. We're actually opening up diagnostics to the world. So one of the first grants I got was the NSERC Discovery Grant, which allowed us to do some basic research. So the first set of grants I got from NSERC allowed me to do those basic studies, and it provided me a foundation to build my research around, right? And then they continue to support me through the years, starting off with building materials, using those materials to build the platform. So that took another 4 to 8 years. And now the next 2 years we'll be building a prototype, then it allows us to test these principles. So that's where NSERC has been a great help in terms of our research.